Time for another one of these obviously obvious spoiler videos, but it's a way for me to discuss spoilers freely with you guys without spoiling it for other people. So this one's all about John Cena, what's gonna happen this Sunday at Fastlane, and what's gonna happen at WrestleMania. Now, the last spoiler video was all about Roman Reigns and how it was obvious that he was gonna go ahead, win the Elimination Chamber match, go on to take on Brock Lesnar at Mania for the Universal title. I think everybody saw that coming. But once again, there's a way for me to discuss the spoilers with you guys and also kind of break the news to people that, look, Roman's winning. Finn's not winning. I know you want to see Finn win the match, but he's not winning the match. I know you want to see Braun win the match, but he's not winning the match. Roman is winning. Somebody in the comments section of that video was like, okay, let's make a deal then. If Roman doesn't win the match, you still keep the video up. Like, Roman wasn't going to win the match. Regardless of the outcome, man, even if Roman didn't win, I was still gonna keep the video up. I'm not gonna go ahead and delete a video like, oh, I'm gonna pretend that I never said this because it turned out to be wrong. No, I'd still keep it up, even if I do end up being wrong. I'm not gonna hide from any predictions or any spoiler videos that I make. So, anyways, let's go ahead and get on to John Cena. So, this Sunday, Fastlane, we've got the six-man match for the WWE Championship. If you're going into this hoping and thinking that John Cena is going to become a 17-time world champion and go into Mania as a champion, sorry to break it to you, but chances are that's not going to happen. I'm not going to say 100% it's not going to happen, because you never know, some plans might change, but I'd say a 98% chance that it doesn't happen. Look, John Cena is not going to WrestleMania to take on Shinsuke Nakamura and AJ Styles in a triple threat match. I know some people, just because he mentioned that match in the first place and also mentioned becoming a 17-time world champion, are all of a sudden thinking that, hey, maybe the plans have been changed. Maybe now John Cena is going to become a 17-time champion and that's going to be the match at Mania. I highly doubt it. Besides, John Cena mentioning that he's going to become a 17-time champion leading up to a championship match, that's nothing new. That's something everybody does leading up to a title match. I mean, just recently, Jinder Mahal said that he was going to become a 2-time champion when he was going to take on AJ Styles. Did that happen? No. And countless other people mention that. Especially when it's towards WrestleMania time, they talk about how they're going to win the title match before WrestleMania and then go on to Mania as the champion and defend it against this guy or this guy. And, you know, oftentimes it doesn't happen. The way I see it too is this whole thing where John Cena goes to SmackDown to find his road to WrestleMania is part of the storyline and is a way to deter the people's attention for a bit from what's actually going to happen, and that is John Cena versus the impossible opponent, The Undertaker. Like, it's not impossible. They wouldn't have had John Cena mention it in a promo if it wasn't gonna happen. They just wouldn't have mentioned The Undertaker at all if they knew that they couldn't do Cena versus The Undertaker. Initially, the rumors a couple months back were just that Cena was gonna have a big match at WrestleMania. I didn't say who, it just said that they had big plans for Cena Mania. And then that big plan was set to be John Cena versus The Undertaker. But then recently, we also got some new rumors from other sources saying that it might be John Cena versus Rey Mysterio. But then thankfully, it was said once again that the plans are still on for Cena versus The Undertaker, not Cena versus Rey Mysterio, which I was happy about. Because Cena versus Rey Mysterio, that makes no sense. That is such a random match. As soon as I saw those rumors, I was like, no, please, please, no. I don't want Cena versus Rey Mysterio at WrestleMania. Not saying that Rey Mysterio is not good, because I like Rey Mysterio, but it is such a random match. It's such a random WrestleMania feud. Between Cena and Rey Mysterio, or Cena and Taker, I'll take Cena and Taker any day. At least when it comes to WrestleMania. We're talking about just a random match on an episode of Raw, maybe for like a number one contendership or something like that, then maybe in that case I would pick Cena and Rey Mysterio over Cena and Taker, because Rey Mysterio obviously moves a lot better than Taker at this point in time. And so I think if they just had a random singles match on an episode of Raw or something like that, then Cena and Rey would be the better match. But when it comes to WrestleMania and WrestleMania feuds, it doesn't get much bigger than a feud in the match against The Undertaker. And let's face it, man, Cena vs. The Undertaker, it's a match that a lot of us have been wanting to see. And despite the match happening now instead of a couple years ago when a lot of us wanted to see it, I still want to see the match. And as much as I didn't want Taker to come back and wrestle again, Once again, not because I don't like The Undertaker, but because Taker now is not the same Taker as years ago. We guys saw how, you know, he was in the Rumble and also his last match at Mania against Roman Reigns. He was moving pretty slow. You could tell the guy was in pain. Now he's got the hip replacement, so it'll be interesting to see how that affects things. If he's going to move better or not. I mean, Hulk Hogan, I believe, got a hip replacement as well, and because of it, I believe, he can't do the leg drop anymore. So, I'm not expecting Taker to say F it and hit the leg drop anyways, but I'm looking forward to seeing how Taker moves, how the match plays out, the actual build for the match, and how Taker returns. I'd love to see Taker return tomorrow, Sunday at Fastlane, after the title match, which, by the way, I think AJ is going to retain. After that title match, they go ahead and have John Cena alone in the ring, and he's like depressed that, you know, his road to WrestleMania is like over because he lost, you know, the Rumble, he lost the Elimination Chamber, and now he lost the championship match. What's he gonna do? And then, you know, you hear Taker's gong, let's go out, and Taker shows up. Or they could just go ahead and have a little tease at Fastlane where Taker's gong hits, let's go out, let's come back on, but Taker's not there. And then John Cena on Raw's like, yo, what is up with that? He calls out The Undertaker because of that. And then Taker shows up. Cena could be like, last night, the impossible happened. The man I thought was retired came back. And then Taker goes, retirement. The only thing I will retire are my balls in your mouth. John Cena at WrestleMania, you will rest in peace. Okay, maybe not the part about Taker's balls, but the rest of it you can definitely expect. You know, the whole classic Taker rest in peace promo. But now before I get to a question that I want to ask you guys, I want to go over some of the indications that you can spot that this match is actually taking place at Mania, not just when it comes to rumors, but just going by what's actually going on TV and how this is very similar to another previous storyline that involved The Undertaker. So, in this case, they've got John Cena trying to get a spot at WrestleMania. His first attempt was the actual Rumble match. Win the Rumble, and then he gets an automatic title shot at Mania. Easy enough, right? Obviously, he loses that. So then his second attempt was to get inside the Elimination Chamber match and win the number one contendership that way. Obviously, he failed at that. He lost the match. And then his third attempt was to move to SmackDown and get into the championship match at Fastlane, which he did, which he will lose tomorrow on Sunday. And so that's multiple attempts right there, which he fails at getting a spot at Mania. Now, he's not directly chasing Taker, but he also went ahead and brought up the match, so he obviously wants it to happen, but he thinks it's impossible. This storyline right here, where Cena tries time after time after time to get a spot at Mania or a match at Mania, is very similar to, can you guys guess it? I'm gonna give you guys 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1 to type it in the comment section. It's very similar to the HBK storyline. Not the first one for WrestleMania 25, talking about HBK trying to get the match with Taker the second time around for WrestleMania 26. He was desperate to get that match with Taker. And the first time around, he just tried to ask Taker for the match, for the rematch. Taker refused. So then his second attempt was to go ahead and win the Rumble match, and that way he could go ahead and just challenge Taker for the championship, because at the time, The Undertaker was the champion. He lost the Rumble match. Batista eliminated him, so that was out. He needed to find another option. His third option was to try and get drafted to SmackDown and get in the Elimination Chamber match. So as you can see right here, it's very similar to the whole John Cena thing. And, you know, he tried to convince Teddy Long to draft him, put him in the Chamber match. Teddy Long said he couldn't do it because the match was already set up. He couldn't do anything about it. HBK got mad about that, so he ended up super kicking Teddy Long. And then he found a way. He decided to go ahead and get involved in the Chamber match anyways. He sneaked in the Elimination Chamber and cost The Undertaker his championship. So that way, he got his title match against Taker. Taker was then mad at HBK, and the match was made. And in this case, it's really the same thing. I mean, he's not directly going after The Undertaker, but it's very much like the HBK storyline, where he tries time after time after time to get a match, a big match at Mania, but keeps on failing. But then eventually, he finds that match. And for the past like 8 years or so, that match ends up being The Undertaker. It's also kind of like, you know, Brock and CM Punk, when they got their matches with The Undertaker, they were trying to make it to Mania as the champion, they failed to do so, and then the next big thing was a match with The Undertaker. So bottom line, it's not just the rumors that point to Cena versus Taker at Mania, but also history, because of how similar this storyline is to how other superstars got their Mania match against Taker in the past. So that is pretty much it for the video, but before I let you guys go, first off, if you enjoyed it, click the like button down below, and second of all, I got a question to ask you guys. I'm gonna list 3 matches, and I want you guys in the comment section to put them in order from the one you want to see the most to the one you want to see the least at WrestleMania. The 3 matches are Cena vs. Undertaker, AJ Styles vs. Shinsuke Nakamura, and Roman Reigns vs. Brock Lesnar. Number 1 would be the one you want to see the most, and number 3 would be the one you want to see the least. For me, I just gave you guys the order right there. It's Cena vs. Taker at the top, and then AJ vs. Shinsuke, and then Roman vs. Brock Lesnar. So yeah, man, looking forward to Cena vs. Taker. I wonder what the outcome's gonna be. Right now, I'm thinking Taker wins the match, but that could change the closer we get to Mania. I'm out, guys. See ya.